加萨人道危机持续恶化，联合国也表示，光是过去三天就有十名工作人员在加萨不幸遇难。而加萨秩序崩解也迫使联合国关闭了四座物资分配中心。此外，目前还有大约600名美国人受困加萨，但是哈马斯却是千方百计阻挠外国人离开。对此，白宫表示，哈马斯提出了多项放行条件，更要求一定要获得满足才肯放人。
29号，联合国卡车再度将大量物资送进加萨。美国国务院表示，当天进入加萨的卡车多达45辆，是以哈开战以来最多的一次。但这些物资恐怕看得到拿不到，因为日前传出物资遭到掠夺，迫使联合国关闭四座物资分配中心。
People are desperate, and that's why we're seeing the breakdown in the law and order, if I may call it that. And it's not just WFP warehouses that were looted. The UNRWA warehouse, which is a bigger warehouse, was looted.
联合国不仅要担心物资被抢，也得面临炮火威胁。光是28到30号，联合国就有10名工作人员在加萨丧命。10月7号以来，联合国员工已经有多达63人遇难。而滞留当地的外国人同样处在水深火热当中。
We've run out of drinking water yesterday as the desalination station that's nearby that we've been relying on has run out of fuel to run the generators.
受困加萨的美国民众表示，现在每天上街找水已经是加萨常态，物资不足，更有人为粮食大打出手。目前还有大约600名美国人受困加萨。但哈马斯却千方百计不准外国人离开。
Hamas has been preventing their departure and making a series of demands. I can't go through those demands in public, but that is the subject of the discussions and the negotiations that are ongoing.
离开加萨无望，同样受困的 CNN 制作人担心自己遇难后，孩子不知道如何照顾自己，于是开始教导孩童煮饭。战火下的孩子被迫提前长大。陈伟仁编译。